Hello everyone. In previous videos, we have seen how to install Python and how to write a program for Python. What are all the expressions, like how to enter expressions in the Python and what are the variables and what is the type of strings and all you have in the Python programming. So now, with the help of all those, we will first write the program. Like we'll write first program in the Python. So to write first program in the Python, we need IDLE or interactive shell for writing and executing the Python programming. So here, if you write your Python program in interactive shell, it is very difficult to rewrite it again and again once it is executed. So what we will do, we will use any text editor, write our program in the text editor and then execute it. So IDLE also provides an editor by itself. We can make use of it or we can make use of any text editors, but the program should be saved with the help of .py extension. So first we will open the IDLE or interactive shell. Go to search IDLE. We got IDLE 3.8. Open it. So once you have IDLE window, it's easy to write a program here. Print hello. It got executed, but if I want to retrieve the file or if I want to open the print file, it's very hard. Like I need to start writing a program every time and execute it. So what I'll use, I'll make use of editor. So this IDLE or interactive shell also provides editor. To open that, I have to click on file, new file. So I'll be opened with a new file. So what I'll do, I'll write a program here. Print hello everyone. Close the string and so my program is written. Then I have to save. So what I'll do, I'll go to file, save as, or I can use alt shift plus s for save as. Open, you'll be having the folder where your Python is installed. You can save your file here also, or you can select any source to save the file. So I'll save on desktop and just keep hello.py or hello1.py, because hello was already there in the file, means hello.py is already existing. So I'll give hello1.py in the desktop. I'll save. So file is saved with hello1.py. So what I have to do, hello.py file is saved. Then once a file is saved, we have to execute the program. To execute the program, I have to use run module. So output will be shown in interactive shell. So this is our interactive shell with the prompt. This is our program within the editor. So click run module. So the file from user admin desktop hello.py got executed and the output is hello everyone. Or I can just press F5, the file is executed. This is how we make use of IDLE editor for executing our program. Close this. We'll keep this for next program. Come back to our PPT. So this is how our program is executed. So we have hello world to save the file, file save as, file name.py to execute the program, run module, or press F5. It's not any key with F5, it's just F5. So next, example program. So here we have an example program where we'll start executing this, and I'll explain what this program is about. So control tree. I'll go here. Before that, I have my program written in the text editor. So I'll go there. Open with ideally 32-bit. So the program is shown. So this is our program from the textbook, a first program of your Python. So I'll go to the program. It says nothing. It is just to tell hello and ask your name, and it should print a hello statement with your name, and it should count what is the number of characters in your name, and it has to ask for the age. So print hello world. So print what is your name. So it is just using two printf statements. One is to print hello world. Next is what is your name. So it is asking a question, means it will print a question, what is your name. To collect the input, we use my name input. So my name is a variable. Input is a statement used to read the values from user or read the values from the interactive shell. So printf, it is good to meet you plus my name. To print the variable my name, we use keyword plus with the variable name. So next one is the length of your name is. So it is calculating the length, L-E-N, of your name, like our string functions. And this is a string function used to calculate length from the string, length and the variable name. It finds the length of your name, then print length, then what is your age. It is asking for your age. Age is saved in my age. So next it will be printing you will be plus string int my age. See here, my age is taken input from the user, and input what it is scanning always will be in the string format. So it is converting the string to integer. My age is converted to integer and added with 1. Before printing, it is converted back to string and in age, because you are printing a string statement here. So we'll execute it. We'll take our run module. So here is our thing, executable window. What is your name? I'm Soumya. So it's good to meet you, Soumya. The length of your name is 6. S O S is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's correct. What is your age? I'll give some random 20. So it is showing you will be 21 next year, or you will be 21 in a year. So this is our first program written in Python. So I hope you understood how to write your first program and execute. Now we will go to the PPT. We'll see how you are desiccating your program. So in your previous program or the program here, we'll take the program path. So program here, what we have, this is our program, and this is how your program is desiccated. First one is comment. In the Python program, the comment is written with hash. If you write hash, the next line or the next statement what you are writing will be considered as comment. Next one is print function. So print function is very easy. No need of printf, semicolons and all. Just write print, open brace and close brace. Whatever you write inside the print with single quote will be printed. So here, if you want to print a variable, no need of writing. percentage d and the address and all, where you want to print the value, there you just write plus. Plus indicates you are adding a variable and the variable name. So plus my name is added to print statement. Next one is input. Input function is used to read the values. So if you want to read the values given by the user, you have to use the function called input. So inputs reads the value from the interactive shell which is given by the user and printed in the printed or it is stored in the variable next to it or which is assigned with equal symbol or assign operator. So the values input reads always will be in string format. Next one is printing a username. So here you are printing my name, like you are copied a name from interactive shell or you have read the name from read value, like reading the value with the help of input. And if you want to print that, you are using plus symbol for writing the values from variable. So it is good to meet you is just a string, will be printed as it is. If you use plus and my name, it prints the value inside the my name. Next one is length function. Length is a function from string, like it's a string function. Whatever the string you pass to the length function, it finds the length of that string. So it finds the length what you have given. Like if your name has 6 characters, then length my name will find the value as 6 and that will be printed. Next one is str int and float. See here, str is used to represent string, int is used to represent integer, float is used to represent float. So to convert from any value to like any data type to other data type, we use this function. So the data my age read by input will be stored in string. You cannot perform addition and subtraction or any mathematical. So we use int of my age. You are converting my age to integer, adding with 1, then convert it back to string. It will be printed in the printf statement. This is how your program is desiccated with respect to the functions and specifications. Like in other hand, this is how it shows the program to write, or it is showing the syntax of the program how you write. Next one is string int float functions. As I told, whatever the value you read from the input, it is represented as string. So we use these functions to change your type of a data or to use them as it is. So we use string 0 here, that is implemented like this, like that is shown as single quote 0. If you use int 42, then it is comes out of semicolon, sorry, single inverted commas, and it is shown as value. If it is int 1.25, the floating value is converted to whole number, and if it is floating point 3.14, floating point will be printed. If it is float 10, the integer 10 is converted to 10.0 as floating value. So here we have another examples of integer. What I told, input is always retrieves the value in the form of string. So span input 101 is read as a string 101. To convert it back to integer, what we have to do, span equal to int of span, where the span which was in the form of string is converted to integer. So we use int function here. Like that we can use string, int and float functions to convert from one data type to other data types. So here this is how your statement, print statement from our first program is simplified. So we know my age was read from interactive window, so that is taken as string. So if my age was 4, then int, it was in string plus 1. So what happens? Int converts 4 in the form of string to integer value. Now you can add 4 plus 1, 5. Again, string function is used to convert 5 in the form of integer back to string. So you will be 5 plus in a year. So you are adding this value to this printf statement again. So the last printf statement what you will get is you will be 5 in a year. So I guess you understood the topic. Thank you.